Good day, peoples. We're here in São Simão, in Portugal, no Alentejo, to continue the ride that we've been doing, the off-road. Not off-road anymore. I got invited for lunch, and by now it's past 3 o'clock, and I'm on a mission to get to Algarve, and we still got to do over almost 400 kilometers. So yeah, this is going to be a ride into the night. Normally I have all the time in the world, but today I got to keep on riding, because tomorrow it's Christmas. So I'm going to get with my family. How are you all doing, by the way? We got Atlas here. We drew some first blood today. Well, that was yesterday, but she got really dirty with the off-road. We're gonna go back to it, but like I said, no more time for that. Let's go. Right, welcome back to an episode how to spend over an hour in one place. Let's go. We can't win them all. Because at the end of the day, it's a whimsical ride. Because Pedro has to be home on time for Christmas. Well, his family is eagerly awaiting him, hoping that he can make it. Because today is the 23rd of December. And tomorrow it's Christmas. Will he make it down? Who knows? Anyway, Santa's got shit on me in his corporate Coca-Cola truck trying to do his thing for Christmas. How about you getting into adventure riding, buddy? Whee! Thank God it's Christmas. Right, going to backtrack? Take a different... Maps Me always shows little off-road tracks, which is nice. I'm gonna find one that takes me to the main road and we can go around this, I hope. Whew. It's not even lunchtime and I'm halfway knackered. That's right, I haven't forgot about this. I don't want a lot for Christmas. I just want to fall in the puddle and I... Underneath the crisp, see how easy it can be. Also let quite some more air out of the tire since I last encountered that puddle. See, almost there. Should be here. And I remember looking at this. Oh, it would suck if I have to go through here with all that grass. Now it just looks easy peasy, you know? Just more slippery to grass. Hey, oh shit, wrong turn. I just want you on my own. On a road you never know where it's gonna end. All I want for Christmas is a track. With not too much angle, not too vertical. So where is it? Must be this one then. Yep. I don't care about the grass or the muddy puddles, no. All that I just don't want is a steep incline, no. Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas. Oh yeah. All right, let's see where we go from here. I can go around it, but also need to stock up on water. Okay, I spotted a village nearby with a fountain of youth. Now we're back on the hard stuff. Pretty low tire pressure. All I want for Christmas is water. Beleza. Pé de serra. Ah, look at the nice little village. It's more colorful here. I love these little dizer. It's quiet little mountain towns where nothing ever happens. Uh-oh. Me, what are you doing? Did you just forget the road? No, you already drove past it, mate. No way. Did drive right past you.
Really see if it's drinkable or not. I think it is.
Because of this sign, which says it's drinkable, but then it looks like it's been removed or something,
faded. English, wow, I'm three quarters knackered, actually. I'm not used to this anymore, man. Anyway, I went to ask this just to confirm if the water was drinkable. And there's a bunch of lads, looks like it's skinning an animal. He says, yes. And it looked like you could use a beer. So I've been offered a beer. And let's go down there.
In the next episode of Cold Ones, Pedro meets a couple of mountain lads. Offer him a beer. Alright, I just gotta find them. They're over there. Stop. Boa tarde.
Fala o seu clube.
Diga.
Fala o seu clube.
Meu clube!
Olha para a bandeira, olha para a bandeira, senão...
Ih, porquê, pá? Estão tão longe da cidade, dessa cidade, e mesmo assim... Por favor!
Isto não é taverna!
Ah, entendo, entendo! Isto é... Boa gente! É o que é! Ah, então, como é que chama-se em português este processo?
É matança, desmanchar o borrego.
Desmanchar? Desmanchar o borrego.
Matou-se e agora está-se a desmanchar.
It's a graphic, peoples. Ah, a gente não pode com isso.
Então, não. Ah, e se tivesse aqui o pan?
O?
Partido o pan.
O que é o pan?
Dos animais.
Ah, esse é português?
É
só chorar. É assim, isto é, antigamente era de todo lado, assim,
sim,
de todo lado.
Sim.
É que eu vim lá de ontem da Beira Alta, a aldeia onde a minha mãezinha tem a casinha.
Tá.
Também falava, era antigamente, o porquinho, o cabrito.
Olha,
as minis. Muito obrigado, amigo. Saúde. O senhor conseguiu ver, precisava de um. Conseguir um caminho, eu cheguei a um ponto ali, a subida era assim, e muito escadas de pedradas. Duas vezes tive de voltar para trás. O meu pneu é para trilha, mas não é trilha. Então eu queria dar a voltinha para entrar pelo outro lado. Só que agora, cervejinha, tranquilo. Eu tenho que chegar ao Lolé para o Natal. Então,
o Natal, depois da manhã.
Pois é, então tenho que chegar. Mas...
Amanhã
é
mesmo.
Olha, obrigado.
Vou fazer. Cuidado.
So here they're in the process of skinning the animal. Você tem caldezinho, uma sopinha?
Não, isto é arroz.
Arroz?
É arroz para levar depois a carne que já ali está.
Ah. Olha a carninha.
É.
That's the meat. Muito bom. Saquejinho de?
Ovelha e cabra.
Ovelha e cabra.
É aqui de cima, Monte Queimado.
Monte Queimado. The cheese from Monte Queimado. E põe um sal.
Põe sal.
Para o sabor, é também para o sabor?
Exatamente.
A little bit of thick, coarse salt for the flavor.
Vamos embora. Vamos embora, tens de ficar aqui assim. Estás bem um bocado.
Não
vai
nada, não
vejo
que
a gente
está aqui.
O arroz.
Cabidela.
Cabidela.
Tu vais almoçar
aqui. Tira, tira. Luís, chega aqui.
Aí, os comentários vão adorar isto. Há alguma gente.
Olha lá.
É assim. A companhia é boa.
Queres abrir a jaula?
In Portugal, you have three big clubs.
Sporting.
Benfica.
No.
Sporting.
Number one.
And Porto. And here, that's that sort of thing is still massive. Sporting is from Lisbon. Benfica is from Lisbon, and Porto is from Porto.
Como é que chama?
Matos.
José Matos.
José Matos. Obrigado pelo convite. Thanks for the invite. O vinhozinho, epá, eu ia depois ter que ir para o Algarve, caraças.
Posso fazer? Ficas a intervir a ver no
sábado. Olha, vocês depois falam com a minha mãe. I'm coming home today.
Como é que disseste chamado?
Pedro.
Pedro, queres vinho ou cerveja?
Olha, quer provar o vinhozinho.
Vinho é bom, uma categoria.
Sim, um vinhozinho. Pois não, é que o mundo fica sempre outros países. Os americanos, quando provem o vinho português, eles ficam, epá, como é que isto é possível? É tão bom, tão barato, e não dá dor de cabeça. É. Portuguese wine is one of the best kept secrets in the world.
Os americanos têm bom vinho da Califórnia.
Ah, tem.
Está bom, galera.
Obrigado, está bom, está bom.
Olha o queijinho bonitinho.
É, mas fica, fica... mas assim, somos obrigados a quase a comê-lo todo.
Ah, é, há de ser um grande trabalho para fazer.
Ah,
olha, foi feito há meia hora.
Pois é, este queijo foi feito há meia hora.
Half hour old, this cheese.
Bom, é amanhã, comida amanhã.
Então,
isso é que é.
Dá aí para me chamar o bife.
Espera aí, só um bocadinho. Fresquinho, pá. Nice. Turns out we're already in Alentejo aqui.
É verdade.
Esta comidinha Alentejo.
No bar do Sporting.
O bar particular, não é?
Do Sporting. É particular. Particular.
Não é para toda a gente. É clube privado aqui.
É. Aqui é como está naqueles clubes, consumo obrigatório gratuito. Sabe o que é que eu disse?
What they call it? It's a mandatory free consumption here. So, pois é.
Sim. Uma coisa só que em inglês.
Sim.
And that means that whatever happens in the club, you have to do it. So, drink well and eat well. E aqui temos um arrozinho com qual era o
cabidela.
Cabidela.
É com a linha.
Obrigado.
É com o sangue do galo.
Que as coisas não sejam.
Com o sangue do galo e com a
combinada. Cabidela. It's chicken e é cozido no sangue então.
Não, você leva no fim.
É no fim. Do galo.
E leva, então, it's chicken with blood of the cock, the rooster.
Isso
é correto, não é? Quem fala em inglês um pouquinho aqui? Um little bit.
Eu falar...
Mas isto é...
Você quer mais...
This is Alentejo, é comidinha de Alentejo?
É, faz aí muito lá.
Não é só Alentejo.
Eits Marlik, bom aproveito.
É um prato regional português.
Deixa-me ajudar aí. Espera aí.
Muito bem.
Mostra-te
Portugal,
claro.
Eu já não tive cá 10 anos, mas eu... É a primeira vez que eu estou a viajar com a bota que eu adoro.
Portugal é um país formidável para se viver, se a pessoa tiver dinheiro e saúde. Não há igual em lado nenhum. Podem vir com cartinhas com aquilo que quiser.
Saúde, cafezinho.
Olha lá, os cantores de paz.
Só falta a água benta.
Só falta a brasileira.
É, água benta, a água.
Olha aí o varão.
Eu já pensei em ter o varão.
Pode ser dia que está
lá. O varão.
O quê?
O varão.
isso?
Uma bola de verão?
Não, um varão.
Aqui no cantinho, assim. Aquilo é água benta, olha. Essa é só para tomar ao fim do dia.
Pois.
I would love to try it, but that's one for the end of the day.
So it's called
Pedrinho.
Medronho. Aguarde. Cuidado com a voz. Sim, cuidadinho.
Just a little bit, for the taste.
Posso dizer uma coisa?
Conformes para a tua mãe. Só vais amanhã dormir ali.
I've been saying I have to get home for Christmas. Otherwise my mother, you know, will come and kill you guys. He said, you can sleep on the couch. But Mats keeps saying, careful with the bike. But you have to try just a little bit of this wine. Or just a little bit of this. It's made from medronho, but I don't know in Portuguese what medronho is in English. But it's homemade, has a very suave taste. And this is like schnapps strength. But the best is always homemade, and this one is made here in the village or nearby.
This is medronho, but I don't know what that kind of fruit is in English.
Max, eu também tenho que voltar a trabalhar. Back to work, sim, sim. Só não vestir outra vez. É que eu não ando assim, pá.
Boa viagem e com cuidado, que as motos são um cavalo
perigo. Muito obrigado. Lolé.
Ei,
mas não vou mais caminho de chão, pá. Já acabou, pode ir.
Forçaram-me para comer e beber um bocadinho aqui. Não tive escolha.
E descansar.
Não tive escolha.
Mas nada.
Vá, Pedro, o que é que tu fizeste, Matos? Deixa-me ir.
À próxima, paras outra vez.
Está bem. Vamos meter uma estrelinha no mapa.
So what a day today. We had to abandon some off-road. I was going to find a way around after getting some water to get back on it. But then Mats here offered me a nice place for food and a little bit of drink. And the day is gone. I got to get down south to Algarve for Christmas, so I got to keep going.
Convido o Pedro e os amigos dele, quando por cá passarem,
no retiro do Leão.
Do Leão do Sporting Lisboa.
Do José do Matos. Onde consumo é obrigatório.
Gratuito.
Pois, so there you go.
Gratuito, sabes o que é gratuito?
Sim, é grátis.
Sim, grátis.
Muito obrigado, Matos.
Nada, Pedro. Cidades, tudo corre bem para ti, hein?
Obrigado, um Feliz Natal.
Feliz Natal, pá.
Cavalheiros também, Feliz Natal.
Olha, não queres dar
um toque. Oh, this is brilliant. In the next town, Nisa, 10 kilometers, I need to fuel up and fill up on tire pressure, get some air. Joe! You're saying go careful. I had to pace myself, you know, a little bit with the wine and whatnot. Alright, folks, let's go to the Algarve into the night for Christmas. Wow, like an old castle or something. Olá, boa tarde.
Boa tarde.
A bomba de gasolina, uma aqui.
Olha, lá por aqui,
sim. Sim.
Sempre
andar
por aqui.
Não é?
É.
Olha para aqui que
eu explico
aqui.
Está bem. Obrigado. Está bem por ali.
Espera aí.
Sim, boa tarde.
Tá. Agora vá sempre aqui para essa calçada abaixo, vai encontrar lá um arco cheio de oliveira.
Sim.
Deixa ligeiramente as oliveiras à esquerda e você vai na rua da direita, sempre à direita, que pelou uma bomba da Galp logo ali na rua.
Tá bem.
Ah, obrigado.
Muito obrigado. Boa tarde. Pronto. I like how the houses become colorful down here. I can't believe I'm fueling up at 3:30 to still do pretty much 400 kilometers. Oh, what a beautiful day. We'll do 2:30 in the back. Always fun. Whoever invented this thing hates motorcyclists. Looks we got some water in there. All right. Now we're ready for a 360 kilometer ride. Altogether, take about 5 hours, depending if I stop a lot or not, maybe longer. We are passing through Évora with about an hour and a half of daylight, tops two left. So let's go for real. This is the place I wanted to get at, off-road, Porto Alegre. Originally my mission for the day. Looks like they have a old castle monastery on the top of the hill too over there. Direction of Évora. There it is. That Volvo is driving really fast on the 90 road. He's doing about 110 at least. And now he's behind a driving school car. But the funny thing is, he's pretty much still, he's tailgating a driving school car. Like that car is gonna go any faster all of a sudden. Because he can, there's a teacher in there. But still tailgating, nothing's gonna change, but he overtook me in a mild corner. So I went all the way to the right-hand side. Over there is Évora. One of the oldest cities, if not the oldest, in Portugal. I want to catch the city center still. I made sure I got here on time while we still got the last light of twilight to have a look at it. Here you have the walls of Évora, built by the Romans. So this city was already a settlement before the Romans came and took it, of the Celtics, the Lusitani people that I've talked about multiple times. OG Portuguese. The Romans came and they made this major establishment for the region. So you got the aqueduct and they built the walls around the city too. And inside the city, that's the cool thing about Évora here. Look at this. Marvelous. The cool thing about Évora I want to show you is what's inside. Look at this. This is a very old city. The Celtics were here already thousands of years before the Romans came. But inside the city, you'll see a Roman temple. And I still have vague memories from being there as a kid. Look at this. It's like one of those, it's like the villages we've seen on the way down for Alentejo, but city size. This is mad, this place. It's like a village behaving like a city. But Évora is definitely one of those special places, unique places in Portugal. Oh, let's go check. I know it's over there, but this looks cool. Just like Coimbra, it's just stuffed to the brim with history. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, my Google. Look at this. Oh man, I've been this kind of speeding to get here in during twilight still. I need to pee like a mofo. Everything. My pants are still kind of wet, but my feet are just soaking still. Almost there to the highlight of the city. The Roman temple. Oh, I thought I could ride around it. Can I? Can I? Sweet. Just look at this. Forgive me that I can't show you this during the proper day, but here we are. I didn't give a damn when I saw this as a kid, and now I'm like, holy shit, that's the coolest thing ever. A Roman temple. There is so much history in this country. You wouldn't believe it. It's just an amazing thing. I've said this before, but there's just so much history in this country and beauty, and it's all kind of compact. As you've seen so far, you got beautiful mountains, beautiful landscapes, beautiful cities, beautiful towns, and you got some awesome rides to do on tarmac and off-road. We gotta go down to Algarve. Christmas is calling. The family's waiting. Let's go, Atlas. So I'm gonna start the final dash of the day of about 250 kilometers. Let's go. All right, Gente. Let's go to the Algarve, and I don't think I'll be recording too much on the way there once it's dark. Almodóvar. Well, like I said, it was going to get dark after Évora, and we still got the hills of Alentejo until then and a bit after that, which is very nice. And then slowly the land flattens out and Algarve begins. Night riding can be a lot of fun, or and we got a twisty road out here for the last 50 k's. Aha, I remember this corner. We're north of Lolé. They are almost there. That was some fun night riding. Takes a bit longer, still did some decent time though. We earned some experience points of doing corners in the pitch black. I found that my right-handers are, as usual, better than my left-handers.
So welcome to the Algarve, the most well-known region in Portugal because of tourism, obviously. But we made it down here in time for Christmas. Will he make it? You know, that was the question we were asking this morning, based on the gnarly roads we were taking. And I just find it funny how I ride around, get some water turned into a, well, big-ass lunch, and the rest was history, but that was really cool. So I'll be spending Christmas here with the family, and I hope that you all out there have one great Christmas, or a good ride-mas, if you get the time to put one in. Enjoy that, you know, you get only so much time off in a year, right? Bit of a hectic day, it was a lot of fun, you know, highs and lows. But those make the memorable days, and I'll be telling this story, all right, of what we've been up to today. Take it easy out there, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.